Prologue. We led to believe that a plot apocalypse will happen. All at once, cinema, graphic novel, even the Bible, presents us with a rapture narrative, whereby suddenly, wave after wave of evil and decay will instantly wash over civilization, till civilization itself is washed away into the sea, as though it is nothing but sandcastles built by children. At least in the biblical version, the good people are snatched up by God and taken somewhere better, while all the evil people are left to duke it out on the good old earth. In our version, the good people are all gone, but not to a better place. All the kind, helpful, benevolent souls are either enslaved or decapitated by those with a more practical disposition. But here we are, with a family who have managed to secure the most valuable possessions, some food, welter, weapons, a car, other previously common items, have since become commodities in their world. What is more surprising about this bunch, however, is just how trusting they are, not just of my brother and me. To be sure, people still travel in groups, of course, still safer, but these groups are made of people that are interchangeable, people who's regularly deserted and betrayed as the need arose. In contrast with a prevailing norm, these benevolent fools are actually a legitimate family. There's a mother who's kind, wholesome and charitable, a father who's stern and loving, a pair of girls, no older than 15, but no younger than 11, the names which I don't care to remember, and a dog. The nuclear family is a rare find these days. Mothers often abandon their children, forge unions with powerful leaders, not interested in taking on liabilities like children. Fathers trade daughters for supplies. That is, if they don't make use of the girls themselves. Brothers and sisters betray and even murder one another for morsels of food or some other scraps. No, the family unit is just a relic of a time long since past.